Okay. I'll just okay. Let's use this website only. Push, oh, sorry, Shashank's website. That is Pranita's. In today's class, we will learn about page builder. Page builder is nothing but till now you have created a website or you have created pages, home page, about us page. Every page you have created, you have added content. You have added content for yourself. That means you have clicked on block, image block, paragraph block, headline block, each and every block, and you are doing the hard work. You are doing your hard work completely. Now, page builder is nothing but everything will be inbuilt. Everything will be inbuilt. You have to just edit. That means some text will be there, some XYZ text will be there. Just remove that text and add your own text. Some random image will be there. Remove that image and add your own image. Social icons will be there, such as Facebook, Insta, and all. Just click on those options and give the link of your own accounts. Everything will be very easy. That means complete page will be built, complete website will be built. You have to just edit that complete website. That is known as a page builder. There are some page builders such as Elementor, Divi. Divi is not a free page builder, but it's very good page builder, Divi. And WP Bakery page builder. These are some of the page builders. We will be using Elementor because mostly 90% of Elementor is free and it is very easy plugin to be used. That is very easy page builder which we can use. Now Elementor is a page builder and also a plugin. Same like contact form, like chat by subsystem. Elementor is a page builder and also a plugin. So to install a plugin, what should I do first? To create a plugin, what I need to do first? I need to go into plugins and click on add new. After clicking on add new, my plugin is not installed. So I have to click on search bar and I have to enter Elementor. Elementor is a page builder where everything will be inbuilt and you have to just edit it. Now Elementor website builder. Elementor website builder, click on install now. After that, activate that page, activate that plugin. Okay, I have installed a plugin called Elementor, which is also a page builder or a website builder. Now, activate. I have activated the page builder. So all my plugins I can see over here, these all are my plugins. And Elementor is also my plugin. I have installed and activated the plugin called Elementor. Elementor will be somewhere appearing on the dashboard. Yes, it is over here. Now, today what I will do is, today we will do two things. First thing is, we will build a page with the help of Elementor. That means we will do the hard work, but we will take the help of Elementor. Second thing is, Elementor will build a page. We will use Elementor and we will take an inbuilt page and we will edit those things. First, we will do hard thing. Later, we will do easy thing. First, we will only build a page with the help of Elementor. Second, we will take an inbuilt page of Elementor and we will edit the changes. So now I want to create a page with the help of Elementor. To create a page, where should I go? I need to go into pages. So I want to create a page called some random page I'm taking, some XYZ page. I want to create a page called test. So click on add new pages and add new. And create a page called text. You can give any your own name, whichever name you want to give, you give your name. So now I'm creating a page called test and then publish. Now, I hope you guys can observe this button called edit with Elementor. Till now, we have never seen this button called edit with Elementor. But today, you guys are seeing this button. Why we are seeing this button is because I have installed a plugin or a page builder called Elementor. Now I want to build a page called test with the help of Elementor. So don't click on this plus option and build a page. Don't add content like this. This is basic option. Now I'm using advanced option, that is Elementor options. So I want to build a page with the help of Elementor. So I need to click on edit with Elementor. Because I'm not clicking on add block. That is basic method. I'm doing edit with Elementor. I have created a page called test and I have previously installed a plugin called Elementor. Now I'm clicking on edit with Elementor. Now, Elementor has its own dashboard. This is Elementor dashboard. These are known as, each and everything is known as widget, or it can be called as add-ons. It is your wish. Now, what I want to do is, I want to create a page like ODMT. ODMT homepage, let's assume. I want to create a page like that. Now, how to create a page? The add block option was there. Here, can you see this plus option? Click on this plus option, add new section option. First, I want to give a title. I want to give a title to my page. So I'll be taking this option. See here, many columns are there. How you want your column to be, you can choose those options. For the first time, I'm using only one option. Sorry, one column. So I have chosen this particular column and I have clicked on that particular column. Now, here in this column, I want to give some heading, that is online digital marketing training. So click on heading and drag and drop that heading over here. Drag that add-on and drop it over here. Now add your text here. He's telling me you can add your text here like this, or you can add your text here also. It's up to you. Now I'm giving a text called online digital marketing training. Online digital marketing training. If somebody clicks on online digital marketing training, you want them to redirect to some other page, then you can give the link of that particular web, that particular page. Just go to, suppose you want to give a link to courses page, then you go to courses page, take that link and copy that, paste that link over here. Then what will happen? When somebody click on online digital marketing, they will directly land into that particular page. Now size, small, medium, however you want to set the size, you can set the size like this. See, in basic website designing, okay, you have some options, but you don't have to this level options. In with the help of Elementor, you can design much better. Default is also not looking good. So let's take large. Now, alignment, where you want, left, center, right, justified. So I'm giving it center. Now, okay, I have chosen one column, and then I have chosen an add-on called heading, and I have dragged and dropped the add-on. And if I want to give a link, I'll be giving size and alignment. Now coming to style, suppose I want to change the color of the text, and here white color is there, right? Background is white, and I want to give some background color over there. Just go into style option and click on text color. However you want to change the color, you can change the color according to your wish. Okay, now I have given some color over here. Okay, now go back. Typography, click on typography. What is typography? See, family, by default it is Roboto. I will change the family to something other one. However you want, you can change the text font and everything. This is looking good, so I want to keep it like that. If you want to increase the size, then you can increase the size. However you want, you can increase the size. For now, I'm keeping it this much. Now weight, if you want to increase the weight, see, nor default, it is this. And normal, it will reduce. And if you want to keep bold, you can keep it as bold. Transform option, suppose you want uppercase, lowercase, capitalize, everything is capital only, normal, all these things I can do. Style, normal, italic means it will change to italic, oblique, then it will change to oblique. For now, I'm keeping it as default. Now, decoration, if you want underline, then you can choose underline. Overline, you can choose overline. Line through, everything will be cut down. Anything you can choose according to your wish. Line height, the height. See, now the height will increase. Just observe. Line height will increase. So you can choose anything. For now, I'm keeping it as like this. Letter spacing. The space between two letters will increase. Just observe. The space between two letters will increase. I'm keeping it as like this. Then text shadow. What is text shadow is? Now here some text is there. Surrounding to text, some shadow will be there. Then you can choose that shadow. Can you see, guys, the changes? Blur it is. some shadow is appearing to me. Before, nothing was there. Now some shadow, blue color, light blue color, some shadow is appearing. Now horizontal, and if you want your shadow to be vertical, then you can choose the shadow to be vertical. See, the shadow is moving up and down. However you want, you can choose that. So now I'm just adjusting it. Blur. Okay. This is about text shadow. Blend mode, what is blend mode? Okay, normal only, let's keep it as normal. Now go to advanced options. Okay, now here if you want to increase the margin between two lines, then you can increase the margin. Just click on increase the number, then the margin will be increased. But for now, I'm keeping it as like this. Right side margin you want to increase, right side. Bottom margin you want to increase or decrease, then you can click on these numbers. Padding is nothing but the space between two lines. You can increase the space or decrease the space according to your wish. Then motion effects. Now see, for pop-up, I have just shown you fading down, fading right and fading left. All those things you can use that. Fade in is this option. Fade in down means from top to bottom. Fade in left means it will become like this. Fade in right. These things will not look good for professional or any serve, like, you know, for a institute kind of website, these kind of things will not look good. But if you are into some entertaining or some attractive website, if your niche is some attractive niche such as wedding photography, jewelry brand or interior designing, at that time these kind of things will look good. But for institutes and all, these kind of things will not look good. Animation delay, that means this animation is happening, right? Fade in, fade out, or whatever it is. But how many seconds you want to delay that animation, for how many minutes or how many seconds, that is, what is this, whatever it is, for how many seconds you want to delay it, you can choose that. Now background, for this particular text there is no background. Background is white. If I want to give some color over here, or if I want to give an image to that background. Now this size is very less, so image will not suit over here, but I can give some color to it. So go into background and click on background type. If you have any image and you want your image to appear over here, then you can choose it, but image will not look good over here. So I'm not choosing image, I'm just choosing color. So click on color and change the color over here according to your wish. For now, I'm just keeping it like this. Then border type, solid means some line is appearing to us. Double, then daughter means some dots will be appearing. Then dash, some lines will be appearing. Then groove, one single line is appearing. For now, I'll keep it as solid. Then width of the border. If you want to increase the width, then you can increase the width. If you want to decrease the width, you can decrease the width. Top, right, bottom, left, and everything. Then border color also you can change according to your wish. The black, red, whatever it is, you can change it to your wish. Okay, I'll just keep it as like this. Then box shadow. See the shadow. If you want to keep the shadow, you keep the shadow. Otherwise, don't keep the shadow. Vertical. Chatbot is disturbing a lot, right? It is distracting me. Yeah. Now, however you want, you can just choose that. Shadow blur. If you want to blur it and everything, you can just choose it according to your wish. For now, I'm just keeping it like this. Yeah. Then mask. See, mask is nothing but what will happen is your text will not appear. That means it will be masked. Only some circle kind of thing will appear, and which will not look good. But I'll just show it to you guys. See, like this it will appear. It will not look good. You can just choose the shape of the mask also. But it will not look good. So I'm just offing that option called mask. Positioning. width and all, you can just see. Okay. This is how much deeply you can edit with the help of Elementor. Now, I don't want this widget to appear on the sidebar. I want my whole page only to be of full width. So what I have to do for that is go into settings option, which is in the bottom left. Just click on it and page layout is default. I'm just doing it as Elementor full width. At that time, all these options will not appear. And it will not distract me also. I'll just close this pop-up over here. All my sidebar, nothing sidebar will not appear now. Now it will look, whatever the designing part you are doing, it will look attractive because before it was not looking good. That is the reason, just to make sure sidebar is not there in your particular page or in your website, go into settings, page layout, it will be default. From default, change it to Elementor full width. Okay, now I have given that heading. I want to give some image and some text. Now I'll be using a two columns. So now in this column, I'll be choosing image, and in this column, I'll be choosing some headline. Now I want to add some image. So click on that particular option, choose image. Go to your upload files, select files. And if you have any image with you, choose that particular image. For now, I'm taking this particular image, website design, and insert media. Okay, my image has been inserted. Image size you want to increase or decrease, medium, thumbnail, it will be reduced. Large, you can increase the size. However you want, you can set the image size. Then alignment, where you want your image to be, center, right, and all. It will look good for alignment, will look good for medium size of images, because for large size, obviously it will occupy whole place. Now, I'll keep it as center. And caption, custom caption, enter your image caption. Suppose I'm not giving anything good caption over here, just XYZ, I'm giving something, then your caption will appear bottom of the image. So for now, I'm not choosing anything. And link, suppose you want to give link to your image. Somebody clicks on your image and they will be landing to some other page of your website. Then take that, copy that URL and paste that URL over here. So when somebody copies that, sorry, when somebody clicks on that for this particular image, they will be landing into that particular web, that particular page of your website. Now here I have chosen image size as medium. I have chosen this image size wantedly as medium because I want to show one option. Large image will look good, but I have chosen medium because I want to give background color to this particular image. To give background color, go into advanced, background, same like what you have did for heading, background type, color, and choose some color. It's up to you. But if you want to change the image size to large, then you can change the image size to large. It's up to you. Add your heading text over here. Just click over here. Just click over here. Then you can add your heading text over here. For now, I don't have any content. So I'll go into ODMT and I will copy and paste the content over here. Take this content, come back over here and paste the content over here. Digital marketing has a link over there. That is the reason I have digital marketing. Okay. Now, if you want to give any link, suppose you want to give a link to this particular word, then choose this particular word. One second. If you want to change the size, you can change the size, medium. However you want, you can do it. Alignment, center, right, whatever it is, you can just do it. Then go into style. Text color, you want to change the text color, you guys can change the text color. Then typography, size, you want to increase the size, then you can increase the size. Weight, you can do it as normal or bold or default. Default is also not looking good. And again, uppercase, lowercase, capital, whatever it is, you can do it. Styles you can change from top, italics, obliques, and all underline. If you want to underline, you can underline. But I'm keeping it as default. Line, see, there was no height between two lines. It was messy, so I have just increased the line height so that some space will be there between two lines. Letter spacing also you can do, but letter spacing is not required for this text. Yes, now I have done some letter spacing. You can change the color also over here. Now in advanced options, same margin, motion effects, background, border, everything if you want to give, then you can do it. Okay, now I will use some other option. Four columns I'm using, and in first column I'll give some heading. Just take this heading add on and drop it over here. Again, here also, if you want to give some heading, drop it over here. Again, click on this nine dots option. Again, drop it. Again, click on this particular option. Then take this heading add on and take this heading add-on and drop it over here. Now, here I want to describe about SEO. So I'm just changing and I'm giving it as SEO. Here I want to describe it as Google Ads. So I'm just changing it as Google Ads. Here, website designing. And here, I want it as social media. Okay, now I have chosen four columns and I have given headings to my columns. But now I want to describe about SEO. I want to describe about Google Ads. Then what I need to do? Just click on these options, and this is text editor in the, that means text. Just take this add-on and drop it over here. Now again, go to this option and again take this text editor and drop it below Google Ads. Same like that for website designing. You guys, please drop it. I'm unable to. Okay, now we have done with website design. Yes, now here I want to describe something about SEO, so just click over here and backspace everything. For now, I'm taking this content. Copy, come back over here and paste it over here. Again, same for Google Ads. Copy some content. That means for your websites, don't copy. For if you're practicing, then you can copy. Then paste it over here. Then for website designing, also same thing. Why you guys are so silent? Are you guys there?
Yes, yes, we are following you.
Pranita, you?
Yeah, I am there.
Okay. Then again, I'm removing this thing and I'm copying this over here. Now, could still tell me if I want to give some background color over here. See, this background color is empty, right? Some text is there, but I want to give some background color. How can I give a background color to SEO? Okay, let's see from one by one options. All the designing part we can do in three options, that is content, style, and advanced. In content option, can I give a color? I can give title. If I want the alignment to be a center, then I can click on center. Okay, then let's see in style. Can we give a background color? We can change the text color from blue color to any other color. Okay, for this color, we have given it as some pink or something. And typography, if you want to line height or family, that means if you want to change the font size and font, then you can click on that. Text shadow, you already know. But okay, content we cannot do, and style we cannot do. Then we can have to go into advanced options. Here, background will be there. And background type, and if you have any image, you can insert image, but there is no problem. But this much size image, this small size image will not be there. If you are inserting any big image also, only some part of the image will only appear over here, which will not look good. That is the reason I'm choosing only color. Then you give any random color over here, whichever colors you feel like giving. My color combinations will be very, very bad. So whatever you want, you can give it. Now, same for this also. Now, click over here. Again, go to advanced options. Go to background and background type. Again, colors. Then you can give any random color over there. Whichever color you want, you can give it. Okay, my color combinations are very bad, guys. Please, you give your proper colors over here. Okay, for now, I'm just keeping it as like this, but you give some good colors. Then same for Google Ads. Now, can you tell Kushtil how to give a background color? In content, you cannot give. In style also, you cannot give. You can just change the text color and the font and give a shadow. Then you have to go into advanced. Here. Background, background type, color. Whichever color you feel like giving, you can give that color over here. It's up to you. I'm just keeping it as in it, like this. Again, for website designing also, just go into advanced options, background and background type, color. Whichever color you feel like giving, you can give it. For same. Again, click over here. If you want to give a background color to this, click over here. If you want to give a background color to this, click over here. Go to advanced options, background, background type, and color. Like this, you can just repeat it over here. Now I'm choosing one more column as. Okay, before choosing one more column, I want to give a button. What button is? Now SEO is there. I have described something about SEO, but I have not described completely about SEO. SEO is a very huge topic. And I have one page dedicated for SEO also. In courses, SEO page is there. Assume that you have your SEO page is filled with SEO content and somebody is in your home page and you want them to redirect them from this particular page to that SEO page. How to do that? You have to choose an option called button. Just insert that button option over here. Yes, insert it like this. Click here. By default, it is telling me to click here, but you can choose it according to your wish. Read more. Click here. Enroll now. Whatever it is. To use such buttons, you have to use button options. To use such whatever. If you want to redirect somebody from one page to other page via read more or enroll now, then you have to choose button option. Okay, I have changed the text to read more. Then, okay, generally these colors will change actually. See, warning is there, danger is there. Warning means yellow color will appear. Danger means some red color will appear. For now, they are not changing, but generally it should change. You guys try it, maybe it will change. The color should change, but it's not changing. Now here, if you want to give some link, that means when somebody clicked on read more option, they have to go to some other page of your website, then give that link over here. Alignment, as you guys already know, where you want to show the read more button, then there you can show. Size is small, you can choose medium according to your wish. It's up to you. Icon. Now, in this read more, nothing, no icon. I have not used any icon. Suppose I want to use some arrow mark and everything. Then you can go into icon library and you can choose here. So many icons are there. You can choose any icon. Now I'll choose this icon and insert a particular icon. See, icon is appearing. Where you want your icon to appear, before the read more or after the read more? You can choose anything, before or after. It's up to you. Icon spacing. See how far you want your read more to be from that particular icon. I'm just keeping it as like this. Like that for every word also, for every service, you can use one particular icon and you can give the link over here. So 100% if you're using some button, then you have to give the link because people will click on button. Suppose you have given read now, read more or learn more or enroll now button. Obviously, people will be clicking on that particular button. So give that link over here. Don't forget to give link over here. Give link so that when somebody clicks on read more, they will land into SEO page. Okay, now we will select some. Okay, I have selected one column. Then go click on this 9 dots option. And suppose you want to insert some video. How to insert? Just take this, drag and drop it over here. By default, some website designing related video will appear over here. YouTube video. If you want to show your own video, that means daily I'll be recording Zoom classes. And suppose I want my Zoom classes video to upload over here. That means, see, daily you'll be seeing those videos, right? Whatever I upload, how will I upload? I will choose this option only. Then I'll select self-hosted because my video is not any YouTube video. It has not been uploaded in YouTube and Vimeo and all also. There are some social media platforms only where you upload video and all. So for now, my video is not any YouTube video. It is self-hosted. That means it is my video, which is in my laptop. So I have to choose the option called self-hosted. If it is a YouTube video, you have to choose YouTube. But now I don't have any YouTube video with me because I don't upload my videos on YouTube. So I'm choosing self-hosted. Go into self-hosted and choose file, choose video and upload files. Wherever your Zoom files are there, you can go into that. You can go into that and you can choose that particular video, click on that particular video, and it will take some time. Zoom recordings, if you want to upload, it will take at least 15 to 20 minutes of time. That is the reason I'm not uploading it now. In the place of self-hosted, I will show you how to upload a YouTube video. Now I have selected the option called YouTube. And here in the place of link, remove this link and give your YouTube video link. Just go to YouTube and give your YouTube video link. What will happen? Your YouTube video will appear over there. ODMT demo I have chosen. And just copy this YouTube video URL. Come back over here and paste that URL over here. Then that YouTube video will appear. Now, if you want to autoplay the video, then you have to click on this particular video. Now see, it is auto playing. I have not clicked on this particular video to start, but it is auto playing because I have chosen the option called auto playing. Play on mobile and all. If you want to mute, then you can use the option called mute and everything. But now I'm just unselecting all these options because I don't want these options over here. And image overlay. See, here by default, some thumbnail is there. This is a thumbnail of this particular video. In case, instead of this thumbnail, you want to insert any your own image. If you want to insert your own image, just go into image overlay, click on show and choose an image over here. If you have any image with you, upload that image, then that own image only will appear over here. But for now, I'm not choosing anything because this thumbnail is good. Let it be like that only. Now I'm choosing some other options. Let's see what are other options. Spacer and divider, you guys already know. Space means some space will be there. Divider means one line will be there. Just take this and upload it over here. See, some boxed kind of thing will appear. For spacer also same. one line has been appeared for a divider. For space, some space will be appearing. Google Maps. You have your institute at some place in Hyderabad or any other location, and you want people to come to that location. How will you show that? How will you tell them that your address? You can use Google Maps. Just take this Google Maps and drag and drop it over here. By default, London map will appear. You have to change and give your own location over here. For now, I'm giving it as Dilshukh Nagar. You guys can give it according to your wish. Hyderabad. Okay, it has appeared, I guess. See, before London map was appearing, but now Dilshukh Nagar, that is Hyderabad, and Dilshukh Nagar surrounding places are appearing to me. That means it is Hyderabad map only. So you can give your exact location over here, exact address, so that when somebody opens your website, they can see the particular location and they can visit your place. You can increase the height of your location. You can zoom the location. However you want, you can adjust it according to your wish. You guys please do it. Now, I'll choose one more option. Just click on this option. Okay, I've clicked. See here, some pro options are there. These all options are locked options. I told you Elementor, mostly Elementor is a free page builder, but some of the options are not free. These are not free options. So don't use these options. These are locked. Okay. Now, yeah, this one. Let's take this. Suppose 100 people have joined your institute or 100 people have joined your course, or at that time, if you want to show that number to the users, whoever visited your website, then you can show that number to them. How many people have joined your course or whatever it is. For now, I'm choosing some 130. Yeah, that means what will user think? 130 people have joined their course. Here, cool number is there as title. I'll remove this cool number and I'll tell us students join, so that people will understand these many people have joined this particular course. Now, animation duration, it is some 2000 or something is there. For how long time you want this animation to run? It is from 0 to 130. How slowly or how fastly? You can choose the particular seconds time over here. Then it will, according to that time, the animation will go on for that many seconds or milliseconds or whatever it is. Now again, I'll choose some more option again. Just go into this particular button, click on that button. And basic gallery, suppose you want to show your trainers, like you want to describe something about your trainers, then at that time you can choose this particular option called basic gallery. See, I have already told you, image is different, gallery is different. Image means only one image. Galleries means number of images. Here, no images selected. That means I have to select some images. Go into upload files. Maybe in media, do we have any images with us? Okay, for now, we don't have any images. So I'm just using these three images, 1, 2, and 3. He is allowing us to choose some 4 images, so I'll select some. 4 images, yes. Create a new gallery. Then all 4 images will be appearing over here. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yes, all the 4 images have been uploaded. 4 columns. And same if you want to link, somebody clicks on this particular image, you want them to go to some other page, then you can give the link over there. And style, you can do style and everything. Spacing between images. Border radius, border type. If you want to give some background color, you can give that background color and everything. Now, okay, this is my page. Suppose I want to give a contact form over here. Then how to give the contact form? Just click over here. Here also short code will be there. Short code, where is the short code? Short code. Okay, first we'll take the social icons. Later we'll search for short code. Just drag and drop it might be some problem to drag and drop. Because I'm doing with my fingers, that is why it is taking some problem. But if you're doing it with mouse, if you're dragging and dropping, then it will, there will be no problem. Now, by default, Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube are appearing. And shape is rounded. If you want to keep it as square shape, then you can select square shape, circle, then you can select circle. Whatever it is, you can select according to your wish. Now, Facebook is there. In case you have a Facebook account, click on Facebook and give your Facebook account URL over here. So somebody clicks on Facebook, they will be landing into your Facebook account. Same for Twitter. If you have Twitter account, just give the link of your Twitter account. YouTube, give the link of your YouTube account. And suppose you have some other social media platforms also. At that time, click on Add New. Click on Add New. By default, WordPress will appear. Go into Icon Library and choose which social media platform you have. Suppose you have Vimeo. Then click on Vimeo. Suppose you have Tumblr, then click on Tumblr. Meetup you have. Anything you can select. Now suppose I have Vimeo, just assume I have Vimeo. Then Vimeo has been appeared over here. Just give them Vimeo URL over here. Again, if you want to change the color, then you can change the colors of this also. See, by default, the logo colors are showing over here. But if you want to change the colors, you can change the colors also. Now, if you want to change the... See, Vimeo color has been changed. It's up to you if you want to change the color. You can change or you can keep it as it is. So like this, you have to give links to your social media platforms. Now I'm selecting this option. And let's upload our contact form over here. I'm just searching over here because I'm unable to find shortcode. Yeah, shortcode is there over here. Just drag and drop the shortcode. Drag and drop. Now. Here, the short code which you have pasted in the contact us page, that short code you have to paste here also. Now, I have not opened my website in a new tab. Can anybody tell me why didn't I open my website in a new tab to see the changes? Today, I didn't open a new tab and I'm not seeing the changes in new tab. I'm doing the changes over here. I'm uploading, I'm doing many changes, but I'm not seeing the changes into new tab by refreshing it. Why didn't I use any new tab today? Yes, why didn't I use any new tab today? You guys know the answer.
It's a plugin. We can see the changes right here.
For pages also, posts also, we can see the changes over there only if you observe. Yes, Kushtis? Why didn't I open a new tab today? And why am I not seeing my changes over there?
Because we have not updated it.
Where we didn't update it?
No, the bottom left, there is an option of update.
Okay, I will update now. Okay, I'll update now. Now can I see, can I open a new tab and will my changes appear?
Apply.
No need to apply. You have updated the changes. It's okay. Okay. See, now I will exit the dashboard. Update. We have already updated the changes, right? Go back to WordPress. Now, what my question is, why didn't I open a new tab and why am I not seeing the changes in a new tab? Now, can you guys answer?
Because we are editing with the help of Elementor.
Okay. So? Did I arrange this page in the menu?
No.
When I didn't arrange that particular test page in the menu, how will it appear in the menu over here? Where can I see that particular page? I will not be able to see that particular page. That is the reason I didn't open new tab and I didn't see this and I didn't refresh it and I'm not seeing it. Because I already know that that particular page will not appear. Because I have not gone into appearance and I have not added that test page to the menu. When I didn't add my page to the menu, how can you think that my page will appear over here to the user? It will not appear. No matter how many beautiful changes you do to your page or a website, you have to go into appearance and you have to go into menu and you have to add that particular page to menu. Then only it will appear to the user. So I have to go into appearance, menu, then add the test page to the menu, save menu, then only it will appear. Test, add to menu. Then test page, we will keep it over here. No, sorry. Test page, we will keep it over here. Save menu. Did you understand, Kushal, why our test page is not appearing over here?
Yes.
Because we have not added to the menu, right? We have created a page for test, but we have to add, what is the second step to create a website? The first is page, the second is menu. You have to add it to the menu. I didn't do that. So I have not, just now I have added it. Then you see your page will appear over here. Just refresh and test page has been appeared over here. Click on test. All your designing part will appear. Now, see over here, in contact us, you have pasted some code. Like this, you have to not see. As a user, I'm seeing this. So I'll just go into pages. The short code which you have pasted in contact us form, I will take that same code and I will paste it in test page also. See, this is a short code. As a user, if you visit your website, you cannot see this short code. Here as a user, I'm visiting this website. See, wp-admin is not there over here. That is the reason I'm not unable to see the short code over here. I'm just directly able to see the contact form over here. I have to go into my WordPress dashboard, then I have to go into contact us page. Then only I'll be able to see the short code. Now I've copied the short code. I will go back and I'll go to my test page and I'll paste the short code over there. Test, click on edit with Elementor, then paste the short code over here. Yes, just scroll down. Yeah, here I have chosen the widget as short code, then I'm pasting the short code over here. See, automatically my contact form is appearing. Now click on update. Click on update. Refresh it over here now because I have uploaded my test page to the menu. Now I can see the test page. Now my contact us form also will appear over here. My contact us form can be anywhere. It can be in contact us page. It can be in phone page. It can be in sidebar. It's up to you. Wherever you want to show, you can show that contact us form. Now I want to show my contact us form in the test page. So I have just copied and pasted the code over here. This is how you design a page by yourself with the help of Elementor. Now, what we will do is, we will create a new page. The first method is done. What I told you, the first method is we will design a page with the help of Elementor. Now what I will do is we will take an inbuilt page and we will just edit it with the help of Elementor. How to get that inbuilt page? See, today we are doing two methods. First is we are designing the website. Sorry, we are designing the page. The second thing is, a page will be inbuilt and we will just edit. In tomorrow's class, whole website, that means all the pages of your website, home, about us, and everything will be inbuilt. You have to just edit it. It's so easy to do. But obviously, the hard things we have to do first, then easy things we have to do later. So now the first method is done. I'll create one more page called some random name I'll give to that page. And we will design that page. That means it will be an inbuilt page, but you have to just edit it. So I'm just taking a page called test new, publish it, then click on edit with Elementor. Previously what we did, we have chosen each and every column and we have dragged and dropped our add-ons in our test page. Here, what we will do is, I'm just selecting it as Elementor full width. I don't want all those things to appear over there. That handshake is very distracting. Okay. Now this option we have used. That is, if you click on this plus symbol, then you can choose any option over there. But now I don't want to use that particular option. Yeah, I don't want to do everything by myself. I don't want to waste my time. Assume that you are, some people will have only one page in their website. Some people will have only one page. Assume that your website is also only one page. At that time, what you have to do, instead of doing whole hard work, don't choose this plus symbol option. Click on this option called add template. What is the template? Everything will be inbuilt. You have to just edit. That means whole theme, it will be like a theme and you have to just edit it here and there. You have to just change image, change text and everything. So I'm not choosing this hard option now. I'm just choosing this easy option called add a template. Here, some pages will be there. Some free pages are there. Some pro pages are there. Don't go for pro pages. You need to pay money. And this is for e-commerce website. See, product app page is there. You can choose this one. You can choose for a restaurant, you can choose this one. For a hotel, you can choose this one. Because we are into digital marketing, I will choose this particular one and click on insert. Click on insert. Connect to template library. It will take some time. Okay, let's see if it gets connected or not, because I don't know if that Gmail ID is working. Okay, it has been working. I have just chosen some page and have clicked on insert. Did it get insert? No. Yeah, now it has been inserted. I have just clicked on insert and the page has been completely inserted. This is the, see what happened over here. Maybe two times I have inserted. I have clicked on the insert button two times. Okay, this is our website. This is our, assume that this is our digital marketing website. See, everything is inbuilt over here. You have a background image, you have some, no need to go into this particular option and drag and drop video, nothing. Your video is there, just click on this video. And if you want to insert your own video, click on this pencil or whatever you call pen. Just remove this URL and paste your own URL. If it is a self-hosted video, click on self-hosted and upload your own video. No need to go into add-ons and drag and drop add-ons. Here also, how to make a website is there. Just click on this pencil symbol. You give your own text over here, online digital marketing and everything. Before, what you were doing everything by yourself. That means whole hard work was there. You have to click on add-on, drag and drop the add-on. Here, nothing like that. Yeah, everything will be inbuilt. Just you have to change the video, change the text, change the image. That's it. And alignment, wherever you want to give the alignment, give it over there. And if you want to change the text color, it is white. If you want to change the text color, you can change. Typography, you can change. The size of the text, you can change. It's up to you. However you want, you can do it. Then line height, you can change. Letter spacing, you can change. Again, same like before only. But here, everything will be inbuilt. What I told, Elementor is a page builder and also a plugin. Page builder in the sense, now did you understand why I said Elementor is a page builder? This page, you did not build or I did not build this page. I'm only editing this page. It has been built by itself. That means Elementor page builder. Elementor has built its own page. Here, instead of this, you can give your own video so that it looks good. So I'll just click on this pencil symbol and remove this URL from here and Okay, code is there. Just go over here, copy the code.
Yes. So welcome to online is the marketing session. Today I'm discussing about what is digital marketing.
Copy this code.
And what
I thought somebody is talking and I'm figuring out who is talking. Okay. Then I have copied and pasted the code over here. Then see our YouTube video will appear over here. Then again, autoplay is by default autoplay is selected. Don't select autoplay. It is up to you whether you want to select or not. But thumbnail, if thumbnail is appearing, then it will look more good, more beautiful. Okay. Now here also some option is there, start a free trial option. You can change the text instead of start a free trial, give enroll now or whatever it is. Enroll now I'm giving. And give the link, contact form link you give, so that when somebody clicks on enroll now, they will go into our contact us page. I'm taking the URL from here and I'm pasting the URL over here. Just a second, guys. Okay. I have given some text. I have given some video. And instead of something was there over here. So I've just removed that and I have given it as enrolled now. And I have given contact us page URL over here. You can just set the alignment wherever you want. You can do it. I'm keeping it as center. And who is it for? Instead of who is it for, you can see some people, as I already told you, some people will have a website of only one page. This kind of things are suited for those kind of people. Don't worry about complete website with lots of pages. Tomorrow you will learn that. But when people have a website of only one page, then they can go for these kind of pages. Now here, who is it for and all, you can give it as what is our vision. Here you can give our vision and mission, whatever it is, you can add it over here. You can change the image over here. Instead of this image, choose your own image and upload that image. Just editing. If something will be there over there, instead of that, you have to give your own text, own image, own URLs and everything. It is that simple. Okay. Alignment. I'll give it a center. Now, can anybody tell me how to give a background color to this image? Yes, Pranita? How do I give a background color?
Advanced.
Okay, advanced.
And then background.
Background. Background type and color. Then you can give any color over here. It's up to you. However you want, you can give. Then our teaching team is there over here. Instead of our teaching team, you can give it as our employees or whatever it is. Just remove this and give your own thing over there. And if you want to give the link, give the link. Alignment, you can set the alignment. If you want to give something, some text color you want to change, you can give text shadow. You can give some text shadow. It's up to you. See some shadow. I'm giving some shadow over there. It's up to you. However you want to do it, you can do. Basically, with the help of Elementor, you can edit. Very keenly you can edit. Now here some our teaching team, some photos are there by default. Just click over here and change the photos and give your own employee photos. And if you want to describe, see everything is a different column. If I want to edit this Stella and all, I have to click on this thing. Again, I have to remove this and I have to give something. If I want to remove this image and give any image, I have to click on image and I have to give some image. Again, if I want to edit this, then I have to click and give some Java or digital marketing. Again, if I want to edit this, again, I have to click on this and I have to remove this text and I have to add my own text. Same for social media also. How to give a link to social media? Just click over here. And for Facebook, give any link. And when somebody clicks on this Facebook button, they will directly go to their Facebook account. Again, here also you can add something about your company. As I already told you, suppose SEO, Google Ads, or whatever it is, you can add anything over here. And here, by default, in this page builder, location is there, working hours, we are here, and everything is there. If you want to change the location, click on this map, pencil symbol. By default, London I will appear and change and give your own location. Then it will change to your own location. Yes, it has been changed to our own location. You can give perfect location also. Working hours, you can change. See, some icon is there over here for working hours. You can just go into icon library and you can choose any icon from this library and click on insert. Automatically, that icon will appear over there. Then working hours is there over here. You can change the title and give whatever title you wish to give. You can change the working hours over here, Monday to Thursday, Monday to Friday, whatever you want to give, give it over there. And for VR here also, you can give your own icon and you can change and give the your own address over here. Just click over here and remove this everything and give your own address. And yeah, actually I've clicked on insert button 2 times. That is the reason again it is showing to me, but generally it will only appear once. And now, okay, you have built this page. That means it is an inbuilt page and you have just edited it. In this website, contact us form is not there. But assume that contact us form is really necessary for your website. And you need a contact form. At that time, what you have to do is, 1 second, I'll just remove that everything. Okay. At that time, now assume that this is an inbuilt website and you have done all the changes. You have edited everything, images, gallery, location, working hours, and everything. But still, in this inbuilt website, contact us form is not there. At that time, if you want to show your contact us form, suppose the website is only of one page, obviously you have to show the contact us form in that particular page only. At that time, click on add new section, choose column, and go to this and search for widget as short code and copy that short code and paste it over here. Sorry, drag and drop. Then here, go to your contact us page. This is, okay, as a user, I have opened the contact us page. WP-admin is not there. You have to go to your contact us page as the owner of your website. Take that short code from there and paste that short code over here. Then click on update. Automatically your contact us form will appear over here. Anything, if you want any add-on which is not in the inbuilt page, just click on this plus icon and apply anything, images, video, whatever it is, buttons and all. Automatically it will appear. Now how to give a contact form over here? Just exit to dashboard. Sorry, first you need to update. First update. Do not just cancel it like that. First update. Okay, it's taking some time to update, I guess. Okay, it has been updated. So exit to dashboard. Then you will be going into your WordPress dashboard. Now here, go back. See here, WP-admin is not there. I visited your website as a user. Now here, WP-admin is there. That means I'm the owner of this website. Now go into contact us form. Here, short code will appear. It will only appear to the owner. It will not appear to the user. Now take this short code over here. From here, go back. Again, which is our test new page. Go into our test new page. Again, click on edit with Elementor. Take that add-on called short code. And in that place, you have to paste this short code. Scroll down. Yes, click over here. Because contact us form is not there by default, I'm just clicking on this and short code, drag and drop the short code. Here, paste the short code and click on update. Now the short code will appear. That is, your contact form will appear. Then somebody can fill the contact form and you'll be getting to know the details of that particular person. Now go back to your WordPress dashboard. Exit to dashboard. did we build all our pages with Elementor or only two pages, test and test new? See, only two pages we have built with Elementor. The first page is we have used Elementor and we built by ourselves. The second page is with the help of Elementor, we have chosen one page builder that is inbuilt page and we have just edited that page. Two are different methods. Both are different. Only for these two, we have chosen Elementor. For every page, we didn't use Elementor. That is the reason you are unable to see any Elementor over here. Suppose for any other page, you want to use Elementor. Suppose assume for courses page, you want to use Elementor and you want to edit with the help of Elementor. You want to add content with the help of Elementor. Click on courses, click on edit with Elementor. Then again, all the Elementor options will appear. Then you can edit with the help of Elementor accordingly. Adding and everything. This is about building a page with the help of Elementor and editing an inbuilt page with the help of Elementor. Both are two different methods. Did you guys understand? Yes, Pranita?
Yeah, I have understood.
Okay.